This is one of the neighbors off of the Western Avenue studios. He still has a glass blower. She's disgusting.
About
2,000 degrees.
2,000 degrees.
She's rolling it.
Back
in, get one more layer, I'll save this, and I'll start slowing. So that's a kiln, and it's got glass in it. He's opening it. This is fun to watch the other people watching him. Look, there it is. Said he teaches classes as well as offers the glass studio where they have the items that are available. And again, there's a crowd. People really like to watch arts and arts being created, and I'm always inclined to stop to watch when somebody's actually painting or making something while they're here. They obviously have to tend their own shop.
Then I'll get back into the furnace. I'll get another layer here.
His studio has a new restaurant, Fat Dog, that's next door to it. And there's a lumber company that's moving out. He said there's a glass supply place that's going to go in there. That'll have things to do with what he does, I gather. I'm on the wrong side now. That's a cup dipped in water that reduces the temperature.
This block's made out of cherry wood.
Oh, it's a piece of wood.
It's dense. It holds the water real well. I just dip it back into the water and the glass rides on a bed of steam as that water evaporates. Once I get it shaped up, that's going to allow me to blow it to get that bubble a little bit larger on the inside of my piece.
Look, the crowd is getting bigger. So he's blowing and it's expanding. He's going to roll it on the table. It's going
to
get a shape.
Glass a little bit by heating it up and let gravity pull it. This is sweet.
Dropping it, and the weight of the glass as he turns it is generating the extension.
So I'm trying to put the glass right in the middle of the pipe all the time. If I stop turning, gravity will just drip it. And I want it to be right in the middle. That's why I'm always turning to try to keep it centered. A little more heat, then at the bench I'm going to use my jacks to make a line in the glass and shape it a little bit more too. So, heat it up.
I'm inevitably on the wrong side of this person.
And I squeeze right here with the jack to make a line where it'll break free of the pipe.
When you're finished with this piece, someone can buy it today?
We're actually recycling everything we make, so it gets thrown away.
She's making him, remaking pieces as he's here.
For to get the size to expand.
A piece that's that size typically costs what?
What's that?
A piece that's that size typically costs
usually
what?
About $30.
To that other base to shape it. You hear the kids crying out, wow. Goodness, see the kid with the helmet and the gloves. They're down there doing the raccoon stuff. I think that's probably my favorite. He's gonna swing it and elongate it.
I used my jacks to cut a line in the glass. Once you get that with steel, you can pull the glass very quickly. So I've got to heat it back up to get that line a little bit tighter. The windy day doesn't really help because the wind blows across the glass and it cools it very quickly. Or differently than it would on a still day, so. There are always lots of different factors to adjust for in the process. The temperature of the heat.
He said he's not going to keep it.